Summoner has changed a lot. Though every expansion, it does change quite a bit, but I appreciate it because, you know, now it's just better and better every single time. Now, I was sponsored by Square Enix to go check out a test build of Shadowbringers, so everything you're going to see here is subject to significantly change. But you can see here is Summoner, here is its book, and it has a very thin dong. It doesn't quite have enough girth for me. Now, the first thing you're going to notice with Summoner is the pets are completely different. As you can see here, the pet hotbar is very blank. All of these old abilities that used to be on the hotbar are now just here. And they're now just player actions. So you see, there's Eggy Assault 1 and Eggy Assault 2. Ruin 4 is not just a 15% chance anymore. It also guarantees a proc on every Eggy Assault ability. So every time you use Eggy Assault, it grants you further ruin, and it stacks. I'm going to show you here. 1, 2, and it gives me 1, 2, 3 stacks of further ruin. I used one and I got another third stack. It can actually stack up to 4, as you can see here. So I used all 4 of my Eggy abilities and it gave me 4 stacks of further ruin. Another thing you'll notice right away is we don't have Aether Flow anymore. Instead, we have Energy Drain, and Energy Drain now gives us 2 stacks of Aether Flow. The other alternative is Energy Siphon, which is right here, and that one will actually give you an AoE version of it and give you 2 Aether Flow. Now, the other thing to keep in mind with that is actually it's a 30-second cooldown. So you actually are gaining an Aether Flow, even though the bar only says 2. You're actually getting 4 Aether Flow a minute now. The other thing is that you go right into Bahamut after 1 Dreadworm chance. This is actually a trait that you get somewhere in the leveling between 70 and 80. And it upgrades Dreadworm Trance to give you 2 stacks of Dreadworm Aether, which unlocks Bahamut right away. Now, there's a big change with Bahamut and his Worm Waves. He doesn't activate Worm Waves off of abilities anymore. He only activates them off of skills. So this is quite a big change because that means you don't have to wait for Aether Flow for Bahamut. You can use him wherever you want and line him up with other raid buffs instead of needing to purposely wait for Aether Flow to be back for him. Now, after Bahamut is ready, you saw my job gauge changed. That will unlock Firebird Trance. And as you're leveling, you get Firebird Trance pretty early, and it acts just like Dreadworm Trance. It just takes over the Dreadworm Trance spot. But later on at level 80, Firebird Trance will upgrade and it'll actually summon Phoenix at the same time. And when he does, he gives you Everlasting Flight. Everlasting Flight is a Medica 2. Summoner has a Medica 2. It's a little smaller, but you see it's right here and the buff is right here. It's 20 seconds, tiny Medica 2. Now, Phoenix does one other thing. It changes 2 of your spells. So we have Ruin 3 and Outburst. Outburst, it's Tribind. They somehow managed to leave Tribind in the game. But it's basically just an AoE version of Ruin 3, and Ruination buffs it too, which we'll talk about later. So you can see when I summon Phoenix, those spells are replaced. Instead, we get Fountain of Fire, and Fountain of Fire will proc Brand of Purgatory, which is an AoE. So you'll use Fountain of Fire single target, and then Brand of Purgatory as an AoE, like a combo. And then it also gets Revelation to replace Akhmorn, and it's the same potency, and you get to do 2 of them in 1 Phoenix. Now, Phoenix has its own version of Worm Wave. It's called Scarlet Flame. I think it's the same potency as Worm Wave. The tooltip says that it works off of all actions, but it doesn't. It works the same way as Worm Wave does. It only works on spells. It does not work on Aether Flow abilities or other OGCDs. Also, here I'm being really stupid and I'm using Ruin 2 because I didn't realize. I'm just in auto habit mode from old Bahamut, but you should really be using Fountain of Fire and Brand the Purgatory when you go into Phoenix. All right, I'm going to show another example here just to very clearly show you that Phoenix only does it. Only does Scarlet Flame on GCDs. So I'm gonna tell Revelation first, and then we're gonna go GCD, OGCD, he didn't do it. GCD, OGCD, he didn't do it. So you can very clearly see that Scarlet Flame only works on GCD spells. And here's the animation up close, summoning Phoenix.
I love it.
There's also a slight difference to Dreadworm Trance. So when you go into it, it actually just reduces your cast time by 2.5 seconds, which effectively makes everything instant. I assume it would also shorten the cast time of Resurrection by 2.5 seconds, but I didn't actually check that. Now, there was something I was wondering because they mentioned switching pets. I was wondering if the Eggy Assault cooldown stayed the same if you switch, and they do. So you could see there, I switched to Ifrit, it was instant cast, but the Eggy Assault cooldowns and the stacks on them, or charges rather, stayed exactly the same. Devotion changed a little bit. It's now just a 5% damage increase to everybody. And Aetherflow ability-wise, you only have Fester and Pain Flare. Bane is still in the game, but it doesn't require Aetherflow anymore. It's just a cooldown. And it also spreads Ruination. So if you were to put your dots up on an enemy, it gives Ruination and the two dots. You Bane it, and it'll spread both of your dots and Ruination to everything. And then you can spam Outburst, and because Outburst's potency is increased by Ruination, you just increased your AoE damage even more. Speaking of increasing damage, Ruin increases its potency by dots now. I kept trying to find reasons why I would want to be switching pets, and it doesn't quite make a lot of sense to me yet. So as far as I could tell right now, you would use Garuda for AoE, and you would use Ifrit for single target. But there may be a small optimal gain if you're switching between the two for Enkindle, or maybe even Garuda's Eggy Assault 2, which does like double the potency of Ifrit's Eggy Assault 2 over a 30 second dot. So I don't want to talk too much about potencies because they could change quite a bit from now until when the expansion releases, so maybe that'll change. But at the moment, that's pretty much where it stands. And that should be everything for Summoner that we know so far. Like I said, there might be little optimizations that's going to change later. That's not really something I had the time to get into while at the media tour, but I'm very excited to work out the real rotation when Shadowbringers comes out. So go take a look on the channel. We're going to be having a video for every job. I'm going to be posting all of them today, so I'll have a playlist link below. Go check them out. So that'll do it for me. I'll see you in the next one.
Dad? Dad?